Hi everyone. I wanted to share with you today a journal that I've made for my granddaughter who's going to be 12 on Monday. And I had gotten this scrapbook kit of papers. It had, 15, 20 papers, 16 papers and 50 stickers in it. And my granddaughter and I had used this when I was home last month making some cards, so I knew she liked it really well. So this is what I came up with. It's very simple. I used 8x8 chipboard for the front and the back and covered the pages inside and out. I used a variety of ribbons on the binding, and I used my cinch bind it and bound it just in the middle with the 12 coils. Then these are old chipboard pieces that I've had forever that were an ugly purple and orange. So I peeled the paper off, put glue on them, then put glitter glue on them, and then let them dry. And it spelled secrets out for her. And then this is one of the stickers, and I used, I don't know whether I can get it here. Let's see if I can get it. Maybe. I don't know. I used glossy accents really, really heavy on it and let it dry overnight. And then I had put it on about 6 layers of cardstock to pop it up and make it look like chipboard. This is another sticker, TTYU, talk to you later. And then I used a variety of flowers. I punched a hole in the front and the back and put brags in, not brags, you know, eyelets in to put the ribbon through to, so, because I was afraid after she started putting clippings and photos and whatnot in it, it would just get bigger and bigger and never stay closed. I used a fishing lure and attached a little heart key. Let me see if I can get that so you can see it. A heart key and the little purse, and the purse was white, so I just used my Copic markers to color it to give it the bluey teal that the rest of the front page was. Same thing with the Prima crystals. I colored them with the same Copic marker to pick up the blue, and some of them are dark, some of them are light, but I like that effect, so I just left it that way. Okay, you simply untie the book, and when you open the front cover, it slides behind instead of over the front. To pull it, goes through the rings, to the back, and out the back to tie. Very simple idea. This is Tim Holtz grunge board, and I sprayed it with a couple glimmer mists. One of the stickers from the book, and I used the glittery glue on the top to give it a glittery sheen. I cut her letters out of those same chipboard pieces that, they're these. This is what I started with. And I've had these laying in the drawer forever and ever. And I just thought, oh, they're so ugly. And then today I thought, oh, gee, why don't I just peel the top off and do something else with them. Gifted Memories is what it says on the back. I think it actually came in an old set I'd gotten from Costco years ago. But anyway, I used the glue on these and the glitter, and then I was afraid the glitter would come off of everything, so I just kind of put glossy accents over the top and patted it in and let it dry overnight. The property of, I don't know, can you get there? See how it's kind of like I've run it through a crimper? What I did was I took a cereal box, and you know how a cereal box is waffled. Then I just folded it at each one of those waffles and then put glossy accents on the letters to give it that kind of crinkle effect. This is a set from Joann's. It has 4 of these little tag things. Here's one here, and there's one on the front. More stickers from the book that I use glossy accents and glitter on. Put some little bling on the little girl's hair and whatnot. And all I did was I made 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different dividers. And they are a piece of white cardstock with the printed paper on the front and the back to give it a little thickness. I did a half circle and put for tabs, and I figured that way if she wants to divide it between journaling and addresses and photos and doodles and whatever, she can design the rest of it however she wants. So basically when you've got the three pages that way, the two paper and the one cardstock, it gives you a nice base for a divider here. On this one, I just took glossy accents. See if you can see it here, maybe, on each one of the little daisy centers, just to give it some dimension. And then in between is just plain papers. They might be white, they might be pink, you'll see as we go along. But it's just plain paper for her to do what she wants. But just a simple little part to go with the rest of her birthday. Here's another sticker, a prima flower. Another sticker that I also popped up on the layers of chipboard and glittered. Put little stones in the flowers to give them more dimension. Seems like my camera's dark today. I'm not sure what's going on here. And then more of the paper. And then on this one I have pink and green papers. This one says Girl Central, and I did the same thing. I glossy accents each letter so that it pops up, and put the Prima bling on it and just some stickers. It's just very, very simple because I want her to be able to personalize it and do what she wants herself. More papers, yellow and beige. And here I've got a little butterfly, handmade flower, another Prima, some Prima bling, a little heart that I found to go in the lots of laughs or laughing out loud, yakety yak, and another little sticker here. Another one of those ones from Joann's. They came four in a package, and I thought they were kind of cute just stuck in. This was kind of a graph paper. Thought maybe she might want to use it for doodling. Who knows? This was a Kaiser Craft set of chipboard, these little pieces that I added to it here. Another one of the stickers out of the set that I popped up, and you can see how thick that makes them just by doing that. Imitation chipboard in a jiffy, you just have to keep gluing and cutting. Added the rhinestones to each one of the tabs because I just thought it made it look a little more blingy for her. And then in the back, what I did was I took an envelope and I covered the envelope and tucked the flap underneath this tie ribbon that goes through the whole book. And when you pull it out, then this will actually be for Zoe to be able to put whatever little trinkets she wants. But this is actually her birthday card with the rest of her birthday present in it. So, and then it just flips down, and I just put some lace on it here just to give it a little something. And then the book just comes around. I put a little note on it that it was to Zoe from Grandma on 2011. And then it just comes around, and when you're finished, you just tie it up. This ribbon has some wire along the edges, so I think it'll hold up pretty well for her. And then we've got the whole book. So that's a neat little idea, very simple for if you've got a tween in your life that's has lots of friends and always into pictures and doodling and whatnots. It would be a nice little gift for them. Okay, that's what I've got for you today. Thanks a lot for tuning in. Don't forget to subscribe and leave me a comment. Love to hear what you're thinking. Bye-bye now.